Congratulations on your curiosity and your bravery. You have chosen to watch this final episode of the Quantum Plan series, and at the end of it, the experience will be beyond anything you can conceive. You will enter the quantum world and merge with this amazing world of probabilities. Because this episode is quite special, we will jump swiftly into the last quantum concept you need to understand to complete your path. Let me introduce you to the existence of antiparticles. At the moment of the Big Bang, unicity of the universe formed itself into the exact same amount of particles and antiparticles. For every single particle that exists in the universe, its antiparticle exists, which has the exact opposite charge. That is how the electron, negative charge, has its positron, positive charge. Or the proton, positive charge, has its antiproton, negative charge. It works like that for all known particles. When a particle meets its antiparticle, they annihilate each other and can create other various particles and antiparticles, or simply release the same amount of energy they were containing. This cycle of particles and antiparticles colliding, annihilating each other, and creating other particles were the basis of the first universe's movement just after the Big Bang. But since then, antiparticles almost disappeared when particles spread all across the universe. The particles won this war, and a whole other possible universe disappeared with this win. The particles now rule the visible world. The antiparticles are clearly the losers, representing today only 0.0001% of the universe. Now we are fully ready to proceed to your teleportation. You know everything you need to know about quantum physics and the quantum plan. Of course, there are still things you don't understand, but it's not your fault. You are just human, and your brain can't grasp the whole plan of the universe. But rest assured, you know enough. I will ask you now to look at these triangles carefully. Don't worry about the process. The sound of my voice will continuously guide you. Now put your hands on your device to make sure you are connected by the sense of touch with these triangles. I'll take care of the rest. I will use antiparticles to make you travel to the quantum world. Don't worry. You are safe. You are about to discover a whole new world. The flesh of your brain will stop limiting you forever. You will incorporate the world of probabilities. An exciting journey is upon you. You just have to let go. I'll take care of the rest. I'll take care of the details. Both hands on your device. Are you ready? I'll count down from three. 3, 2, 1.
Halt! 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 Nein! Aufhören! Sofort aufhören! Halt! Are you still there? Damn, that was close. For those who did, take your hands off the screen right now. What were you thinking? This cat is a liar. He just wants you to disappear. Sorry to interrupt the series like that. Audience. Yes, I will call you that. But I actually just saved you from the claws of a very, very bad kitty. My name is Ruth Georgie Erika Braunitzer, daughter of Dr. Erwin Schrödinger, and I am the original owner of Kitty, this cat you've been dealing with. First of all, I owe you an apology for his behavior. And I'm sorry I have not been able to intervene earlier in this series. This cat really caught me off guard on this one. As for you, my little kitty, you are a very bad cat. You should know it's very dangerous to play with antiparticles like that. Let me explain something to you, audience. This cat doesn't want to save humanity in any way. From the early beginning of humanity, everything he did, despite all he says, had the purpose of annihilating us. The triangle is a lie. The cat just wants to teleport people into it and lock them up forever. You would only be able to come back in ghost form, but then you can say goodbye to your free will. And at the end, you would always end up back in the triangle anyway. He continually snuck lies amongst his true quantum explanations during this whole series. The geniuses he claims to have created, he just tried to destroy them all. All the challenges we are supposed to have failed. There are no challenges. There are only evil creations to twist our minds, always with one unique goal, guiding us to our doom as a species. Oh, little kitty has something to say, apparently. What is it? You are a bit shocked? Believe me, it is not the last surprise you will have from the Schrödinger family. Did you think you could kill my father and get off lightly? When his disease appeared, he understood and trusted me to counter your actions. What I can say for now is that you are not the only one who survived the Schrödinger box experience, my dear cat. We are two of a kind, the same but different. A particle and an antiparticle. A winner and a loser. Oh, my little kitty, please don't be so naive. Despite all your great competences and methods you learned to use, despite all your allies, you didn't succeed in getting rid of humans. You thought your failure was due to your lack of mastering entanglement or in humans' free will. No, my dear cat, it was me. All along, it was me putting spokes in the wheels of your ridiculous quantum plan. I can shape the block universe too. I countered your every move. This war has been running since the dawn of our time without you even understanding its true nature. Confused? Want an illustration? Do you think humans were supposed to eat that much meat? No, my dear cat. The true path of humanity was leading it to veganism. But with you getting so many allies in the animal world, I had to adapt my strategy. And I did it without remorse by inventing the meat industry. Consider yourself lucky. Despite all my efforts, I didn't succeed in making cats tasty enough for most humans. Oh, you have something to say again, kitty. Sorry, but I have decided to leave you speechless from now on. I deem that we have heard enough of you. Yes, my little kitty, I'm sure you understand what is currently happening. This series is mine now. It is time to come back to you, audience. I admit that the cat, despite his evil motivation, did a pretty good job explaining the quantum world to you. But one has to go beyond these quantum explanations to understand the universe. Take this teleportation thing, for example. It's true that at some point we all have to leave this macroscopic world. It is not a sad thing, because it's the very goal of our existence, the very goal of life. Of course, I'm talking about death here, but death is not at all what you think it is. Furthermore, even if he wanted to, this cat could never guide you because he is unable to comprehend the full greatness of this world. But you are. All is destruction. All is creation. All is energy. All is processes, and I will not let the quantum plan destroy humanity. On the contrary, let me take this opportunity to introduce you to some of the cat's ignorances. If you stay with me for season 2 of this series, you will discover the truth beyond the macroscopic, the truth beyond the quantum, the truth beyond the mathematics. This truth is called the pantopy, and it is this pantopy that allows your free will and consciousness to exist. In season 2, we will fully understand how much cats and other animals are inferior to us because, unlike us, they will never be able to take the only path that leads to the pantopy. Transcendence.